This video is about the new ArchiFrame features for the new Archicad 27 release. We are always committed to supporting all new ArchiFrame features for the latest version of Archicad, as well as going back to the two older Archicad releases. The first new feature is the double angled elements and boards. This enables free modeling for roof construction. For example, I will create a structure for a roof using diagonal direction. Here, I have matched the roof top to the joist bottoms to get them nicely visible. Create new element, then I will show the diagonal line using the roof hotspots. So here we have got the boards double angled, and if I hide the layer, you can see that the framing underneath has also got the same orientation. Copy-paste the planks and boards between elements. In this example, I copy the selected door pieces to another element. Please click the link in the video description for a video that covers this topic in more detail. The steps are that I pick these selected pieces to the projection tool. Then I select a part belonging to another element and then click Paste Picked Planks Boards. Now here we can see that we have some clashes, so I'll delete some of the existing studs to ensure it fits accurately. Double Cut, a new option for the Plank Cutting Tool palette. V-Cut is most useful for special rafter shapes, and it can be used in the floor plan, sections and elevation, and even in element drawings. Let's go to the floor plan of the selected rafter and open a section where it is visible. Let's first start by removing the existing cuts at the beginning of the plank. And then, let's draw two lines showing how we want to cut the piece. First, I will draw a line to the middle of the rafter. Then I will draw the second one vertically and adjust the lines. To cut the piece itself, let's select the lines and the target rafter. Here is our result. Now let's look at the same in 3D. Please click the link in the video description for a video that covers this topic in more detail. Archi Corners. Let's add corner planks by selecting the related walls and the trimming roof. Please note that since the upper floor side wall is not cut by the roof, we will extend the corner planks with a value of 1000 mm. We do that here so that the corner planks will for sure be cut by our roof. The material we use is 25 by 150. And the result, we left a 50 mm gap between the corner planks and the roof. Please click the link in the video description for a video covering this topic fully. Now let's add a horizontal element without the related ArchiCAD slab. The bottom level input defines the level of the composite layer selected here, so it is the topmost layer of the floor. Let's first add it looking from top and then from the bottom. The result in 3D. Please note that the plywood top level is 1000 mm in both. Please click the link in the description for the video covering this topic in more detail. Board support pieces options is very useful if you need to have a support behind your connecting boards. For example, let's add support for this wall, first showing only the wall in 3D. Then select the framing layer where the support pieces will be created. Let's see the settings here. To get more information, please remember that you can always get context-sensitive help from any place by pressing the keys Alt-Shift-F1 in Mac Option-Shift-F1. With these settings, we are going to get grooves instead of cutting the pieces between the studs. The most important setting is the spacing rule automatic, which will place the support pieces behind or board edges. And we are using 1mm oversize. Then check this one as on. You can see that we can have separate settings for both the front and the back side. Automatic cut top and bottom. Now there is a setting to include a support piece to the cutting place. Let's do it to this wall. We can override the material specific maximum length setting here. By default, the cut piece's material is used, but it can be selected here. With this setting, we include the support piece. Still, we also need to ensure that this setting is on. Here you can see the result, our cut and support piece. There are a few improvements in the drilling tool. Most importantly, the possibility to use 2D objects to add drillings. In this example, we use 2D hotspots to add drillings to the rafters. First, we pick the hotspots. Then, suspend the groups to get just one target rafter, and with the following settings, 0 jet to drill through, 10mm diameter, and to the front side, we created the drillings and have gotten 6 as expected. Then we must repeat and do the same to the other side. So groups on, pick the drillings, suspend groups, select the target, and do the drillings. Please click the link in the video description for a video that explains the process in more detail. ArchiFrame will support copy and pasting between Archicads, maintaining the relations between ArchiFrame objects, like ArchiFrame elements, to the planks belonging to it, and also the other way around. First, let's see how copy and pasting weatherboards works. Since in Archicad you cannot copy and paste from the 3D window, the weatherboards have been created to the story they appear in. Let's go to the floor plan and select everything in the current layer combination. This is what we have in 3D. Then go back to 2D and copy from here. Then in another Archicad, paste here. And the model in 3D. To show that these weatherboards are linked to the windows, I will move the bottom of the window, and we will see that the weatherboards are automatically updated as well. So the link between the Archicad window and the weatherboard is confirmed. Then let's copy and paste ArchiFrame only parts, the 3D view of these. Here I have the 3D model and the element drawings on the same story to be able to copy and paste also in element drawings. Please note the dimension drawing here. This also works as well. Then let's select everything, copy, open the other Archicad and paste it here. To verify that everything is working okay, let's open the 3D view and edit a stud. Then go to the related element drawing and you will see that it is updated and everything works as if it was originally done in the same file. Please click the link in the video description for the manual section covering this topic in more detail. Go check out the version log for the full list of all the more than 100 new features that have been included in this release.